Hello, 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 welcome, welcome, welcome. Thanks for joining. If you are joining, if you're not joining, then why? Because it's bound to be brilliant. I've just jumped in a race tonight, so I thought I'd go live. Just in case anybody wanted to tune in. Not that many people probably will. Let's just get this set up 1 second. How do I do this? View dashboard. Share, there we go. Right, I don't know the format, don't know anything. I'm winging this massively. Huge wing. This could go terribly bad, ladies and gents. 10-minute qualifying. Crazy's breaking really early there. Sorry, Crazy, I have to get past you, mate. You can have some slipstream now, buddy. So as far as I'm aware, all I know so far is it's 2 races tonight. I think we're at the same track, I don't know.
I literally have no idea. I think early while the kid was awake.
I'll leave. Why? What do you call it? Yeah, I think it's 2 races here. GT3 cars. Qualify is weird the way it works. So, the one rule I read was that yeah, we do qualifying, as you would expect. Yeah, we do qualifying as you'd sort of expect, really. But, what do you call it? It's a reverse grid. So if you get pole time, you start at the back. So I don't get what the point of that is. If you commented, by the way, for some reason my dashboard thing's messed up, so I can't actually see it. So I do apologise. I can't see what you've put. It's been a bit daft. Oh crap, yeah, sorry Bobby. That's me, mate, that's me, that's me. 1 minute. Red X. I know what a red X is, you giant turd. Some more water. Which means I'll need a colossal piss in about 20 minutes time. Opening up. Try and get this going again. Right, I've got my stream up now, but I can't see the last message. So someone did say something because it told me on here. But I didn't see it, so I apologise for that. Yeah, I just entered this league that MRC are running. Aren't you in lobby 2? Now I'm in Bobby's league. Wow. What's going on? All I know is that right ahead of us we've got a 10-minute quali. And a half-hour endurance race. I think the fuel and tyres is times two, so that shouldn't be too bad. We might be able to no-stop it. I don't really know. I will just have to wing it during the race. We're in the Porsche tonight. So the Porsche 911 RSR. The second choice car we've got. Right, so I've gone for a weird choice. I've been told to pick two cars. I'm assuming you use the second car in the second race. And I've gone for the Hyundai. Because it's had a bit of a bop boost. West26, hello. Thanks for tuning in, mate. How you doing, mate? How you doing? Found me. After all these years, I found you. I don't even know if that's a song. It might be. Who knows? This is the thing I hate about these lobbies. It's just waiting. Should be qualifying should be nearly done by now. Yeah, so format. Qualifying, then two races. So the qualifying will determine the grid for race one, but it's a reverse grid. So let's say I get pole, which isn't going to happen, I'll start at the back. The second race is then a reverse grid. So, 5-minute qualifying. All right, okay. So it's literally two laps. Mega. Yes, I'm good with this, mate. I've not had a bad day. Nice and sunny still, so I do like that. Auto track. Yeah, not had a bad day at all. Yeah, I wasn't gonna race in this because normally Mondays I like to just chill out on Monday. You know what I mean. Not really do an awful lot, but I thought while we've got lockdown on, it's not like I'm going gym or anything. I can just do some racing instead. Oh, what you hit me for, you gigantic pleb? Good. What are you up to, Unite? Alright, qualifiers, let's go. So we've got 5 minutes. I'm not going to bother fuel burner out like that. I'm just going to drive. We've got two brake balancers, it's fun in quali. Because I can run this with a Porsche, you do want the front end to bite, so you want all the heat going into the front tyres. Greedy gets us off to a good. Oh, you giant, you plump. Honestly.
To be fair, I'm having a pop at it, but I did the exact same thing. I've just treated this as fun.
Oh, I've got Ghost Realm Gaming, aka Shadow Hunter, aka Bailey, behind me. I might let him go through, see if I can catch a bit of his slip. You can flash your lights at me all you want, Nigel. When I'm racing and stuff, I'm just going to pre-warn you, I'm not very good at reading the chat. We are blessed with quite a long straight here, so I'll try and read it there. But absolutely no promises. Good start, innit? Yeah. Well, it's a good job, mate. No damage on. There's another league that I fill her in for sometimes, and they do heavy damage, so if that had happened in there, game over. So I've come out in time, I should get two laps in. So, ooh, a little bit wide, see what I mean? I was treating this as a filler, not as a filler, as a banker lap. This is an awful lap so far. Guaranteed provisional pole for about 10 seconds. That's quite crazy whacks and absolutely immense lapping. So I'm not taking any major risks on this lap, I just want to get around it quite peacefully. So the aim with this qualifying is literally just put a time on the board that I won't be too disappointed with if it's not that great. So I didn't hook that apex up very well then, so that's going to cost me a few attempts down the straight. 121.4 for crazy, that's a good lap that. 21.5 for me. Good luck, crazy. Right. Let's take a few more risks. See if we can't improve that. This means I'll be starting at the back of the grid, so you earn points for qualifying, by the way, so your qualifying results, by the looks of things, are treated as race results, so effectively you've got three sets of points up for grabs per race night. It's a really weird format, but it's interesting as well, like, it could spruce things up. Don't get in my way, crazy. Thank you, mate. Good on you, pal, good on you. I think he's in the FT1, which is a fast car. The Porsche's probably the best, one of the best all-rounders you've got. It's probably not the best for this track, but it should do. Right, so 21.4 pole. I'm going to try and go for the third. A little bit neater. Fuel isn't an issue. Gonna have about 25 laps in the tank. 30 minutes, 1 minute 20, like, yeah, we're not gonna have issues. So 121.5, 121.4, 121.5, so the consistency is there at least. Would you believe it if I told you that I've not driven the reverse layout of this track before tonight? I've driven the other way quite a lot now, but the reverse, not a chance. So Crazy's in a Subaru. Interesting. Bobby's up there, FT1, it's a quick car, all big wool, he's a fast guy in the 911. A couple of new guys in here. 55.8, aka Billy, he's in here as well. Goes from gaming in the Corvette. Player one, I know he's new to the league. So you've got 14 drivers tonight. I think that's right anyway, is that I'm going to have to start from the back now and fight my way through. So my plan of attack, if this is the case, I'll see in a second. If that is the case, I'm just going to take it steady, lap one. Yeah, I'm right at the back though. I'm right at the back. So, just take it steady, lap one. Let everyone else have accidents, because that'll happen. And then try and work my way up the field. bogged down a little bit on the start there. Fuck's sake. Completely unsighted there by a car that just stopped. I think he'd... because what this game does... is you've got like a start light system, and if you jump the gun, basically, and it's really strange, you don't even ghost out, you just stop on the start finish straight. It's like it stalls your car for you. So Crazy got away well as well, he was up there with me. So 14th to 8th, pretty much straight away. Well, that's because there's been an absolute chaos. I was just about to say then, I'll work with Crazy for a bit because we know he's quick. That was a bit of bumpy then, Bob. I will concede that one. Give me some slipstream, Bob. Give me some slipstream. Car there or what? I think Bob's looking after his tyres here. Bobby's quick. So again, Bobby's someone I might just want to work with a little bit. Get away through the field. I made the apex there, Bob. But I'll let you go back through. Bad news for me is this lead pack, the leader's jumping time on us. So, just want to settle into a rhythm now. After a very bumpy opening few laps. Only Bobby up ahead that I've actually raced with before. I don't think I've ever raced with any of the other blokes, so I don't know what they're like. Console gamer's stuck in a 121.4, so he's got some pace on him. It's hard to keep that pace consistent with him. You need him to break there, Bob. Lots of different lines going on. I'm having to brake in places I don't want to brake. I
Bazinga in. Is that a Supra? It's a quick car. Got his slipstream. Thanks to the leader. Get after him. We know he's quick though, so I'm not expecting to see that time tumbling down. Gained a few tenths, but I think I've lost it all now. In the race. It's too quick, to be fair, for the race. I don't want to be going that fast. I will kill tyres. Noticeable wear on them by the end if we don't pit, but I think we can get away without pitting in. Console game is making a good run for it. I don't know what his real name is. That was a slow lap for me there, that'll be 21.7. So, 4 tenths off. Not best. I did say I wanted to slow it down, but not by mistake. This stage of the race is probably my favourite. It's when everyone just settles into a rhythm. And you start plotting. It'd be nice to be closer to console gamer though. So I'm going to be honest, 5.5 seconds. It's going to be a lot to make up. That sort of gap in F1, you'd know it was game over. It's GT3, so it's doable. 20 minutes in which to do it though. Bobby's now past Bazinga, behind me.
know Bobby's freaking fast, so that's, I'd like to say that's a worrying sign. There's 4 seconds behind at the minute, so I'm not obviously worrying about it right now. If he starts gaining massively later on, then I will. So like I say, I think he's tyre saving. So I don't think that car has to feel safe. So I'll just keep doing what I do. Just keep lapping at this pace. I'm quite comfortable at this pace. I don't feel like I'm pushing the car too much. Took a few attempts out of console game of that lap. I can see him. There. If I was a bit earlier on the throttle, I think I'd get another bit of pace out of that corner. Really nice and steady through there. So now I'm just starting to think about my tyres a little bit. The corners a little bit more, just be really careful. You see it. Just trying to be smooth with my inputs. Only braking 100% when I absolutely need to brake 100%. So, probably won't see any more faster slaps from it. Go another 10th quicker. Just don't want it. I don't even know what track 2 is. No idea. Hand it to console gamer, he's keeping that pace up really nicely. That gap is not moving. Don't get me wrong, I'm not driving to my limit. I'm driving at a decent pace though. If anything, he's pulled a bit more of a gap on me. In fact, he's set a fastest lap at 20.8. So he responded to my 21.0. Went a tenth an hour faster. So he's a fast dude. There's Billy. So about halfway through the race. Certainly not giving up on the win. frustrating because I can see his car every now and again. He's not far enough ahead to let his cars out of sight. He's nowhere near the slipstream or anything. I'm just going to keep myself consistent. Probably about another 5 minutes before the tyres start to go. When they do, I don't think I'll lose a massive amount of time. This is still at 6 seconds. Done good driving by him, whoever he is. Said at the start, I've not driven away a lot of these guys, so I don't know what they're like, and I initially meant that by sportsmanship. Bit of it's coming from me, seeing as I bumbled Bobby off twice, but anyone that knows me knows I do like to race clean. Bobby's pitted. Sitting anywhere else going to the pits. Yellow flags are out then. Getting too excited, it could be a back marker. In fact, I think it is. Console game is still 6 seconds away. That's the thing. That's how kind of lap traffic treats us. Be really careful when you go past lap cars. They should get a little warning on the dash that you come in, so they should get a little flag. A blue flag. So the same sort of thing you see on my screen. They'll get a little blue one. That tells them as a they're about to be lapped. So should we encounter any, that's what we'll see. There's a little bit of a gap between me and the guy ahead, so I think the guy ahead is console gamer. In fact it is, there he goes, look. 6 seconds away is normal. At least at this track, me and Emma nailed on pretty much. Well, he's got a faster lap than me, but pretty similar. But I can see there is traffic. He's got two cars ahead of him. Got enough time to jump into the pits. Do I roll the dice? Bobby's gonna be quick on fresh tyres. Or do I stay out? For the time being, I'm gonna stay out. Dude, did you even know I was there? Jesus Christ. So we're still on the 21s. We've got plenty of fuel. keep an eye on Bobby's delta. He's at 18 seconds now. The check how long the pit stop takes, that's one thing I didn't do. I'm assuming the rule is the same as it is everywhere else, that they don't exactly have to dive out of the way for you. They've got their own races to do. So you're expected to make the move on them cleanly. If anything, the lapping car will be the one that has to get off the racing line to make the move. Get a ton of time to plan them either. See, the rate I'm catching Creeder, looks like I'll probably be on him for the straight. At the current rate I'm catching him, he might have actually less from time to time. So I'll just try and think about when you might want to make this move. Oh no, it's happened for me. I think knowing Shadow on it, he probably took himself off to let me through. I think this first place is well and truly buggered off. 6 minutes remain. Still not really worried about tyres. I'm going to start losing lap time now, but I've got 21 seconds to Bob. That's just to save his tyres a little bit. Probably a little bit too little too late, but that left front's starting to get a bit of a kick in. Back in the 21, so I was up with lap that. what's going on outside my house tonight. All I've heard is horns beeping and bloody people shouting, motorbikes. Third, and look at that, 3 seconds for what? What did I do that justifies a 3 second penalty? You can piss off. Good news is I've got 2 laps to serve that, so it won't be a big deal getting rid of it. Serve 6 times while coasting that corner. Laps. Just get rid of this penalty. There we go. That'll do, mate. Well done to Console Gamer. Go, Jelly, go. You'll have to turn that into a ringtone. Go, Jelly, go, go, go. Happy with that. Considering I've done like 10 minutes practice before the race. Game in the AMG, so yeah, another good all-round car. Again, potentially not the best for the track, but he made it work, so well done to him. What other results do we have? What happened to Bobby? Well, Bobby got himself back into third at the end, just by 3 tenths. That looked like a really good race between Bobby and Crazy. Kilmister and Big Wool in the RSRs, they look quite close as well. Player One finished 7th in his first race, so congrats to him. He had a massive gap over. He was basically in that big pack. And then Bazinga, Gosholm, Cachillo, Glover, DJD, McCreeder, and the 55-8. The 55-8 rounded out the grid. The right now between races. Let's have a look. Look at the state of that car. What was that from? When who did we hit? We did it to someone, didn't we? Can't remember who it was. Save the replay. Oh yeah, who is it? Console Gamer 205. I don't know the next track.
Whether it will be this again, I don't know. I don't think it is.
Yeah, I don't think it is. Cheers, Crazy. Cheers, Big Walt. Cheers, boys. Creed has left. Was it not having fun? And then there were 13. So wait for Bobby to change up the track. See which one it is. Not a bad debut. Oh, is it your debut race? Reverse grid pressure. Oh, right, I'm going to be right at the back here. Need to use second car, don't we? We're having a little break. Right, next car then. So, oh, I should know this track vaguely. I had a race here not long back. What track? I want the Hyundai. I'll go for the softs again. So everyone's going for the power cars. This might be my undoing, this one. this might be my undoing using a Hyundai Genesis at this track, but hey, we'll see. Alright, what am I at? Oh crap, it's reverse. Have I done it reverse yet? I think we did this layout on the GTTCC. I'm just going to have to check. So I've got to go out and do a few laps. What I do like about the Genesis, bright green and red livery. It is... Ah, yes, I know where we are. Though not my best track. Definitely not my best track, but I'm familiar with it, so let's just get some familiarisation in the next few minutes. same track, just a different layout. Turn one here was absolutely deadly. Throw it in. And you have to space in the open stick, so what am I going to do there? This race isn't going to go as well as the last one, I guarantee you that. Gonna be at the back again, starting to last with console gamer next to me. Probably not. No, probably not, man. Not yet practiced that one. Is it, what tracks are we at tomorrow? I know we've got Spa in the wet. What's the other one? Is it Dragon Trap? I had a feeling it was Dragon Trap. Cheers, Bill.
Cheers, pal.
St. Coxey, is it? No, the info thing that James sent to me, definitely, I'm sure it says Dragon Trail. I'll check after this, but I'm certain it's a Dragon Trail. If it's St. Coy, I'll be quite happy with that, to be honest.
A long ass lap there though at sea, isn't it?
St. Clair. Thing is, that's just another alpha track, isn't it? To the equation with a 42.3 here. Probably about ready to get this one on the way. tyres aren't going to be a factor. Fuel might be. How many laps are we going to look at? 30 minutes. 143 a lap, let's say. How many laps are we looking at in 30 minutes? Can anyone do me some quick maths? Going off for 20 laps on board, I think. I can probably strategically save a little bit of fuel. POV did a 325 flat. I'm surprised it didn't too fast. To be fair, the Alpha's probably pretty good at sliding. Well, might be a bit twitchy, but their car should be pretty good at sliding. I'll do a bit of practice tomorrow. Not done any yet. Proper send it now inside the rubber. Sent. Keep tapping that wall. There we go, we're on. I'm just kind of have to wing it with fuel, see how we go. Who knows? I'm only a filler anyway. Wish me luck. So, I'm again at the back. What is console gamers in a suit for? He's an A-rated driver, that's why he's quick. That boy ain't no slouch. He was in a fucking drop-top Volkswagen, Bobby. How careful did everyone take it down there then? What's on the back of Big Wolf's car? Crazy. Talk about moving under braking, pal. Fucking hell. I'm waiting up because it's the right thing to do, but I wasn't at fault for that. But I think there, to be fair to Crazy, you don't really have much choice but move under braking down there. Rapido in a straight line. Short shift to save a little bit of fuel. If anyone is watching and can work out how many laps the race should be, I would appreciate that a lot. So, where are we? Got enough
enough for 20. You know what? I think we'll be fine. Sod it, I'm just gonna go all out. Who cares? What crazy? To be fair, I think you let me go then. I was kind of shoving him down the road a little bit. Why are you breaking fucking Nora? Well, I sped him up a little bit. Sorry for my colourful language. I just get surprised. Chelsea. Oh, lad in the front's got a Chelsea. Gaucheron gaming up in the lead. Catching up to him's not going to happen, I won't lie. It's 12 seconds away, and that gap is only growing. But we'll see what we can do. I don't think a podium's out of the question. Gaucheron gaming is pretty quick on it. Billy in his Rothman's Porsche. Bobby's probably my target, you know. Giving similar pace. Player 1 is driving well. What car is it? It's the same colour as somebody leaving the toilet bowl, well, that's what I do now. Aston, it's a DB1. Is it, no, it's a DB9. GT1 thing. So, at the start of this race, don't forget, was the results of the last race flipped on my head. So, the opening few laps chaos was completely expected.
just don't think I actioned it the right way. Oh god, I'm in the slipstream for this bit. That Aston's quick. Racing in a league, well, in the GT3CC last season, but he, for one reason or another, I just don't think he could make a race. So, yeah, he didn't end up racing. But it's a long standing name in the club. I've still got player one in my touch room, so I've got to be careful about that after mine. Because I haven't got a touch room in the car ahead to defend against it. Good enough exit out of there to keep her on the slip. I think I might have just about done it. Something was missing from my race today though. Consistency. Nowhere near as consistent as what I was on the other track. I think even without the opening lap issue, I'd probably be up in that fight. Winning it, pretty different game. For now, I'm just trying to catch a big wall. Size of a GTR, it's a pain in the arse to overtake them things. Traction they get off the line, I mean, look at it, it just pisses off. Really hard car to overtake. Let's just try and roll up on the back of him and get some slipstream for the straight. Not quite in it yet. A bit more work to do. A bit earlier there, just because I know I'm in the slipstream of another car. Getting past that thing's going to be a pain in the arse then. Chilo next, Spaniard. Tires and fuel both good. roughly at the halfway mark of the race. Maybe another lap will do it. Oh, not too deep there because I was busy looking at something else. That's going to be a big little run on me. About a second between us, so he will be right on my chuff at the end of this. Faster than I expected him to. Gamer, third at the minute for him. Debut race apparently. You stumble on this video and end up watching it. Good debut races, especially with the club. Look forward to seeing you in other events. Not having fun at this track, obviously. Really early, just coast in the corner. To be mindful that I don't smash into the cars ahead. Control game, just got a tap of the wall there. Mate, let's just work together. I don't know if you're watching this, but let's not let third place get away. So either let me go or let's work together. At the minute we're fighting. Possible result for me is a podium. I she's chucking out a little bit dirty. Yeah, I'm not used to driving in it. Second. King of the no stops. Tires are good, not losing pace on them. That's down is pumping that consistency and drop console game on something. I think as soon as I do that, I'll probably be alright. I do still think Bobby and Bailey are just being too far on the road for me to do anything about them. We know those guys are quick anyway. So, anything better than a third place here. I've got a fight on for that. There's console gamers there. It's not going away. Lap he does a lap of the track, he's gaining experience. Also, I'm effectively pulling him along as well. Chatting this one. This is taking a fair bit more focus than the last one did. It's getting good through there now. I knew that was going to happen. I tried to cut him back, but it didn't work. I Tell you what though, I'll give him all the credit in the world, his racecraft's spot on. Absolutely bang on his racecraft. Drive yourself off, I needed your slipstream up there. God damn. 41-0 for Bailey. I'm not going to beat that because I'm not very consistent yet. And I've now got tyre wear to contact with. Not a lot, just a little bit. Bobby is winning the race. There's probably about a 3 second gap between those two guys. Pretty sure Ghost Run Gaming is on Thrust. I'm sure he's pitted. I don't think Bobby's pitted. That's what I meant. When I said I need to be careful there, that is exactly what I meant. Just as the front end doesn't have as much grip as it once did. So you just need to be very careful. Now going to start attacking. That'll be his strat. If he's anything like me, he'll have sat behind me for the last two laps and worked out where I'm not as good. So now we'll be in attack mode, he will. He's spun, I think. Spun right at the end. That was sweaty. Third in the end, not too unhappy about that. Second and a third. Constant pressure throughout that one as well. Who won that then? Let's have a look. Was Bobby... Oh no, Ghost Home Gaming won it. I didn't even save that replay, Bobby. I didn't even get a chance. What the fucking are you doing? Right, well, I think, ladies and gents, that is that. I abruptly ended the lobby, but there we go. Thanks for tuning in.
Please follow if you're not already. I'm on my path to affiliate thingamabob. So let's just check my dashboard actually and just see where we are. Oh, we have. So thank you for Thomas Farrow for the follow, Dexpack for the follow, and Panzemiak for the follow as well. All those new ones have arrived in today. Alright, that's it. What are we on today? Monday. Next action on the channel, back on Twitch on Thursday, is going to be the Next Gen Racing Power Maxed Renault Megane Trophy. I can't remember where we're from this next week. But that league is coming to a close, so catch it while it's hot. That's going to be at 8 o'clock live on Twitch. I will then be uploading it to YouTube, as you would expect. And yeah, that's pretty much it for me. Thank you very much for joining me tonight. Appreciate it. And I'll catch you in the next one. See you later. Bye-bye.